In touch with a forester and just did a property evaluation. And from there it kind of snowballed into them letting us know what programs are available as far as applying for a forest health grant and what we could do to have a safe and healthy forest.
San Mateo RCD hired on resource consulting to fulfill the role of CEQA compliance and permitting compliance to really get the project on the ground, to reduce understory vegetation and promote the residual stand to increase its health and vigor.
People are starting to realize that we do need to actively manage these landscapes, and we do need to go in and thin out the forest and promote diversity and re-implement low intensity disturbance, essentially.
We had fire come up to within 20 feet of all our buildings.
Yeah, that was like totally alarming because the sudden and rapid change in the fire gave us no real evacuation prep time. There's one road in and out, and it goes right through the Girl Scout camp, which means that this project is really put us at ease a bit about just using that as an escape route.
State parks we identified as right next door to the Girl Scout camp, and it would be sort of advantageous of us to continue good work that was completed at the Girl Scout camp and build upon it here at the state park.
And now that we're able to partner with CAL FIRE and RCD, we have access to more resources, more funding, more experience.
Any project we work on is inherently partnership-based. It's us working with a private landowner, it's us working with a public landowner, or it's us working with an agency that helps them manage their landscape. So we can't do projects unless they're partner-based. And specifically these types of projects, California is so far behind in forest management, you need to dip into as many resources as possible to get projects like these done at the pace and scale that they need to be done at.
Yeah, the work wouldn't get done. We wouldn't have the resources, we wouldn't have the knowledge, we wouldn't have the support to do the work in the time that got done here, and it would be an unsafe environment.
A healthy forest now is going to be productive for wildlife habitat. It's going to yield clean water. It's going to sequester carbon at a greater rate than it would otherwise. And it's also going to give us opportunities to work safely should a wildfire occur within the forest.
And hopefully it gets contagious. You know, other property owners and other groups in the area see that and, you know, do the same work that needs to get done.